So I'm going to show you how to transfer this large Morganite. We've cut the pavilion, now we need to cut the crown, so we're going to transfer to the crown. There is an issue with trillion cuts. They don't seem to fit the dops that are available on the market. So we've modified this dop so it will fit the shape of the trillion cut. We put that V groove in it. Michael just went back to the shop and cut it in. So Ultratec, this is a possibility for a new product for you, because the dops that are available definitely don't fit trillion cuts. So in transferring, first thing we're going to want to do is make sure everything is clean. So we use, this is 99% alcohol. You don't want to use regular rubbing alcohol because it has glycerin in it. So we want as pure of alcohol as possible. So clean the stone, clean the dop, assuring a good solid connection with the epoxy. So we had to use a different transfer block just because of the size of this stone doesn't fit the standard Ultratec dop. They do sell one that is bigger that would work for this, but this is one I have for a different machine. So now our gap is gone because we cut that V into it to fit the culet of this trillion cut. Now we'll mix our epoxy. Unlike the first time, I'm going to do this in two separate mixing because it takes so much epoxy to work with this size stone. So I'll mix enough to get inside the dop. So each batch of this, I mix really well, probably a minute and a half of mixing. Takes about 3 minutes for this to start setting up. So I'll start by kind of painting it onto the surface of the Morganite, just to make sure I get a good connection. And then fill the dop. You know, before we didn't fill the dop, but this time it's important at this size stone. And after we're done, we just soak it off anyway. So no reason, just paint it around the stone. So I'm going to mix up another batch just to make sure we get plenty on this stone. Okay, I've got a second batch mixed up here just because of the size of this stone. Let's fill it in. Make sure we have plenty. You could use a bigger dop on this, I suppose, this big stone, but that's as big as I have. I think it's a 16 millimeter. When you're doing smaller stones, one thing, you just want to make sure that the glue doesn't stick out further than the girdle of the stone, just because if you start cutting into glue, it can loosen up the bond. So now once all that's on, you just kind of manipulate it till it gets harder. Just try and get a enough on both the dop and the stone. So now we give this at least a couple hours to get solid. You know, I will wait overnight, a full 24 hours. That'll get you your most solid bond. And then we'll show you how to remove this side using very limited heat so there's no risk to the stone. And that's all about the way we dop this side of the stone without putting glue between the dop and the stone. On this side, we put glue between the dop and the stone because we can soak it off now and just take our time. So it's been about 24 hours and our Morganite is transferred. And now we're going to have to remove the original dop from cutting the pavilion. So here's the new dop we've placed on. And here's the dop we used to cut the pavilion. So now I've got to break this free. And you'll see why I don't put glue between the dop and the stone, particularly when you're cutting the pavilion. And we will now remove the epoxy and remove the dop from our crown, and we'll start cutting the crown. So this is a case where I could use a little bigger X-Acto knife, which I have one at home, but that's not helping us any. So we heat this up good, and we've got a lot of glue to remove there. So this type of dopping, you know, on a Morganite would probably take the heat, but on a stone this expensive, I'm not willing to risk anything. So I'll get the knife good and hot and start removing the epoxy. And again, the size of the stone and the amount of epoxy makes this job a little more difficult. So this method, I'm really not transferring much heat to the stone. Thank you. Sounds like it's moving. Alright, finally popped off. Like I said, this is usually much easier on a small stone. Just a lot of glue to remove. So, now we can get started on cutting the crown. If you enjoyed this video, please like and subscribe and continue on with this as I cut the crown of this large Morganite.